Want to train your team with practical industrial automation courses? Head over to realpars.com/business and fill out the form. Programmable logic controllers receive and transmit analog signals intended to perform various tasks. PLC inputs routinely handle analog signals representing variables such as temperature, pressure, and flow. PLC outputs produce analog signals controlling final actuators, such as valves and dampers. In this video, we will discuss the different types of analog input and output field devices and associated signal conditioning often used. To begin with, let's discuss the difference between a digital signal and an analog signal. The digital part is easy. A digital signal has only two possible conditions: on or off, yes or no, up or down, 1 or 0. Let's look at a pressure switch, a digital field device that operates at a specific pressure of 15 psi. This means the switch is open at pressures below 15 psi and closed at pressures above 15 psi. We can connect this switch to a digital PLC input with a bit of simple wiring. Okay. So here's a question. What if we want to know the exact pressure? Is there a device that will tell us when the pressure is 22 psi or 12 psi? We need a pressure transmitter that produces an analog signal representing the measured pressure. How many possible conditions are there in an analog signal? Well, a lot more than two. In fact, there are an infinite number of possible conditions. Transmitters produce voltage or current analog signals representing process variables, such as pressure and temperature. Okay, let's look at PLC voltage and current analog input signals and where they originate. Typical voltage signals include 1 to 5 volts, 0 to 10 volts, and negative 10 to positive 10 volts. The most commonly used analog signal is 4 to 20 milliamps current. If you're interested in how a transmitter can be physically wired and you're a RealPars member, you can check out this course on transmitter basics. You can find the link in the video description. All right, let's go back to our pressure transmitter problem. How do we know when the pressure is 22 psi or 12 psi? Most transmitters are signal conditioners calibrated to produce a current range of 4 to 20 milliamps, representing a specific pressure range. Okay, so we've got a 4 to 20 milliamp signal representing a specific pressure range that we will send to a PLC analog input module. We can also use the same analog input module for flow and level measurement. Why? Because the 4 to 20 milliamp signal can represent any variable. For example, the Allen-Bradley Control Logic's 1756 IF8 analog input module can connect up to 8 channels or input loops. Again, if you're a RealPars member, you can learn more about how a temperature transmitter can be calibrated in the Transmitter Basics course. Are there analog input modules that connect directly to a sensor, thus eliminating the need for a transmitter? The answer is yes. Resistance temperature detectors, or RTDs, or thermocouples, are used for most industrial temperature sensing. As illustrated earlier, temperature sensors can be connected to a transmitter, producing an analog signal of 4 to 20 milliamps, representing a temperature range. RTDs and thermocouples can be directly connected to a PLC analog input module, such as the Allen-Bradley Control Logic's IRT8i. Eliminating the need for a transmitter. This type of connection has pros and cons. The RTD changes resistance with a temperature change, and a thermocouple produces a change in voltage with a temperature change. Issues with wire length between the RTD and the module, and differing temperatures between the thermocouple sensing location and the module, need attention. Let's discuss the Siemens 7MH4980, an analog input module connecting directly to a load cell. This type of module is often called a load cell input module. Load cells come in different shapes and sizes, depending upon their application, but they all have at least four wires. Two wires are for excitation, and two are for the resulting signal. Let's move on to analog PLC output modules. Analog PLC outputs control devices such as actuators, motors, and control valves. Usually, the module itself does not provide the drive for the controlling device, only the control signal. For example, a pneumatic valve is operated by a current-to-pressure converter, or I-to-P converter, that receives an analog control signal from a PLC output module. Just like on the input side of the PLC, typical output voltage signals include 1 to 5 volts, 0 to 10 volts, and negative 10 to positive 10 volts. The most commonly used analog output signal is a 4 to 20 milliamp current. An example of a typical analog output module is the Allen Bradley Control Logic's 1756 OF8, which can control 8 separate voltage or current devices. That should do it for this video. Okay, let's review. A digital signal has only 2 possible conditions, while an analog signal has infinite possible conditions. Transmitters produce voltage or current analog signals, representing process variables such as pressure and temperature. Typical analog voltage signals include 1 to 5 volts, 0 to 10 volts, and negative 10 to positive 10 volts. The most commonly used analog signal is a 4 to 20 milliamp current. PLC module vendors offer analog input modules that can be used in multiple process variable loops. PLC module vendors offer analog input modules that can connect directly to a sensor, such as an RTD, thermocouple, or load cell. Analog PLC outputs control devices such as actuators, motors, and control valves. Usually, the module itself does not provide the drive for the controlling device, only the control signal.